What are the emotions kind of leading up to the first game?
I think the guys are really excited. Again, it's for everybody across the country, the amount of going against the same team over and over again. But as you know, we got to control those emotions. It's going to come down to the discipline, one play at a time, staying focused, never too high, never too low. We're excited to get our first taste of that this Saturday.
Listen, a moment of sincerity, if I may. This is a big moment for you. I mean, obviously, you've done a lot in your young career, but as being a play caller for an SEC football team, how are you feeling, and do you feel like you're ready for this?
You know, every year I say that, oh, this is a big moment. Then the next moment's the big moment. So it is. It's keep calm, carry on. Every week, every game, every year, just continuing to get better. And I think that, you know, I think about the times I've thought about this is the biggest one and that's the biggest one and this is a big moment. They're all big, and ultimately we all know at the end of the year, sometimes it might be the one that you didn't think was the biggest that ended up being the biggest. So everything we're trying to preach to these guys, our process is our process, and we got to go have a first grade outing.
Marcus obviously talked about, you want to have a win, but besides that, what are some of the things that you're looking for out of your offense in this first game?
Yeah, I think, everything we're talking about right now, we talked about the pre-snap so much, you know, and it's being extremely disciplined in the pre-snap, no pre-snap penalties, getting lined up, knowing what we got to get done. I think the second thing that's been we've been preaching is this make routine routine. Again, the routine plays, we need to go out there and do that over and over again. Certainly in this first one, you know, the owning the line of scrimmage is going to be critical. We've got to play a physical brand of ball and take care of the football.
Marcus talks about how you keep a pretty even-keeled demeanor while you're coaching. How do you preach that to your players so that when the bright lights come on for the first time, they don't get too overexcited?
I think it's different for different guys. You know, it's there's so many battles you have going, one of which is that mental battle, that mental toughness battle. And again, I think the number one thing for us is, can you be at your best regardless of how you're feeling? And that's what we're constantly preaching. So we know that with every guy. Do they have the mental discipline to go out there each play, regardless of what the last play was like, stay focused on their job? I think it's important, if we're preaching that to them, that we got to showcase that too. And that's the number one thing, is for 3 hours in a cell phone area, can you go out there one play at a time, stay focused, and do your job?
Going off of that, this is Brock's first time going into a game as the starting quarterback. Have you seen him change up at all, or is he kind of taking it all in stride?
He's pretty steady, you know, and that's one thing I've always had a lot of respect and appreciated about him. But then again, right, until you get in front of 70,000 at Kroger Field, you never know. I'm sure there's going to be certainly a high level of excitement. But as we know, right, this is every week. It's wanting to play football for a long, long time, and it's the battle against you and yourself, and staying focused and playing at the level you can play at.
Bush, I was going to ask, I noticed in the game notes, you're the only full-time assistant who's going to be up in the box. Was that much of a discussion for you, or did you always know you wanted to be up in the box on game notes?
Yeah, I just think it's a huge advantage. I do. I've really only called a couple games down on the sideline, and there's certainly a ton of distractions. So for me, being able to be up there, again, I've talked about, Derek Shea for a long time. He's a guy that we brought from Marshall, who's been with me. Missouri, he'll be right there with me. And the guys we have upstairs will do a great job of giving us another set of eyes.
It's a 7:45 game. You got your coffee ready?
I do. I might go tea for this one, so I don't know, man. I'll be mixing it all day. So, again, just try to stay as calm and focused as we can be. So.
What about running back? How do you feel about the run game during camp and the running back position in particular?
I think we're excited to see him. You know, that's a position you just never really know. Anytime you're talking about right now with just Demi as the only guy really with game experience, is there a little bit of nervousness or what's it going to look like? Absolutely. But at the same time, as you guys know, that's what college football is all about. The guys that sometimes surprise you in a good way, sometimes surprise you in maybe not as good a way. So we're excited to see that group. I think they got a chip on their shoulder and certainly have a big opportunity for them Saturday.
What does the Southern Miss film tell you, if anything, and does the number of transfers make it more difficult to figure out what they might be?
Yeah, garnished? Great question. I think in general for everybody, right, it makes it hard. You look at us offensively and the different guys we've got in different spots. And so I think that's a challenge every week. Certainly have a lot of respect for Southern Miss. I think they're extremely well coached, certainly do a great job of knowing exactly who they are, disguising their looks, and they're a physical group. They are. We've you know, at different places, played these guys a lot. This is an extremely talented team, always have had a lot of talent. So it's going to be a big-time challenge for us offensively.
What specifically have you seen from just how they operate in the trenches defensively?
Southern Miss?
Yes.
Again, you talked about a lot of the transfers and the guys they brought in. Where they did not bring in a lot of guys is their fronts, you know, and so there's experience there. It's a physical group that's played a lot of football. I think they do an equally good job in their pass rush and stopping the run. And again, this is a good football team.
Bush, we saw how good Demi's hands were here last year. And I mean, obviously you used Ashton a lot in the past game. Is there any kind of comparison there between the two? Or are they kind of?
I hope so, for sure, you know.
I just wasn't trying to throw an unfair comparison out there.
Yeah, Demi's got a lot of versatility. He really does. I think he's a guy that's really been focused. I've talked about just a couple guys since I've been here who in the last 4 or 5 months have come to work every day with that kind of mindset. He is one of those guys. Obviously, it was a pleasure coaching Ashton, and what that guy did for us last year was extremely impressive, and we sure hope we hope they both have great years.
With, I mean, what have you seen from just during camp from a physicality standpoint? We obviously saw him way more in the slot than we did the traditional running back spot last
year. Use that statement with guys, like you hope he's a dog, you know, and he's kind of got that to him. He's physical. He loves the game. He comes to work every day. And that's the biggest thing. I think he's one of those guys. Very rarely is he ever too high, too low. He knows what it takes from a practice standpoint, and he knows what he's got to do to get ready for games.
Bruce, before you got here, they moved Eli between center and guard back and forth. So what about him at center do you particularly like? And what do you do if maybe he's not available at any point at this spot?
Yeah, Eli's one of those guys, the maturity level. I guess he's 23 years old, but he's really like 35 years old in my mind. You know, he's just he's a guy that has played a ton of football. And as you know, there's no replacement to that, especially in this league. We've got a plan in place if something, God forbid, happens to him. But he's just such a solid figure for us in that position. Again, the amount of detail, probably gets less and less as you get further away from the football. So with a guy who's at that center position, your guards, certainly there's a lot on their plate.
Going back to Demi and your overall run game, how much has it helped to face the kind of defensive front that you see every day in practice?
Yeah, it's huge. It's huge. It really is. And I think there's been really good battles for about 3-4 weeks, if not 3-4 months. And again, I think those guys are iron sharpens iron and going against some of the best day in and day out. And so we're excited to cut them loose. Again, I like where that group's at, the consistency, they're growing. But again, bright lights on Saturday. We just got to stay calm and go execute.
It's only Tuesday, but is the opening script, is that finished? Or how does that process work?
Yeah, you just kind of take some time with it. I think there's some superstition to that opening script a little bit. There's certainly, there's like a book Brian Billick wrote like 20 years ago where he lays out like of the 10 plays what they should all accomplish, and I think a lot of coordinators kind of make a checklist, but there's never an exact science. Obviously, we want to know who we're getting the ball to early in those stages. We want to be multiple personnel wise and formation wise to get a feel for confirming some things, but we'll normally Thursday sit around as a staff and see who's got good juju on what that first play is going to be. So
how much lobbying
just sit in that 2 spot for quarterback? Is there any chance you try to get them a few snaps in this first game?
We've been pretty vocal about our quarterback situation. Again, Gavin's really done a tremendous job. I think you guys have seen what he brings to the table from an athleticism standpoint, and certainly from an arm strength standpoint, what he can do. You never are for sure on which direction that would go. Do I think we will see Gavin? There's probably a good chance. And Cutter's just working hard, taking a bunch of reps right now because we know how special he can be. So,
in those staff meetings that you mentioned, how much lobbying do you expect to get from Vince for some 12 and 13
sets? A lot. So I've learned, if I ever say 10 personnel, which means there's no tight ends on the field, or if I've only got one tight in the field, he's normally in my ear. And so, but no, he's been great, man. He's been obviously awesome to work for and work with. And so we're excited to get those guys going.
Thanks, Coach. Thanks, guys.
Appreciate
you.
Thank you.